I want to share a neat trick with you today on how to create a blurry glass effect in Canva. This effect is called glassmorphism, and it's the process of taking an image and making it look like it's behind a blurry or frosted piece of glass. And it's a really cool effect, especially for social media. Well, we can create this by using Canva's photo editing and transparency tools. My name is Kat. This is Canva Catter Day. Let's get to it. You're going to start by just taking your favorite image and dragging it into your design, just like that. Next, you want to decide what shape do you want your glass to have? Do you want it to be square or oval or a circle? And I like to use Canva Frames for this because it has a little more versatility. So go to Frames and click See All, and then just pick your shape. I'm going to choose a rectangle. I'm going to grab this one right here. And then you can make the size adjustments as needed. So there we go. We have that right there. Then you want to take your image again and drag it into the frame. It's going to place itself right inside that frame. Anytime you use frames in Canva, it's going to automatically try to crop that image for you. You can see the framed image is much smaller than the background image. We're going to fix that because for this effect to work, I need both images to be the exact same size. So just double click inside the frame. And you can drag these handles up and down so that it aligns perfectly with the background, just like that. There we go. We look exactly the same. Next, you're going to click inside the frame and we're going to make some photo adjustments. So click on Edit Photo and we're going to use this blur effect right here. And then bring up the intensity. Now, how much you use is entirely up to you. If you want it super blurry, you're gonna bring this intensity all the way up. And if you want it kind of a little middle of the road, you're gonna bring it between like 50 and 70%. I think that's probably good right about there. There we go. It looks fine like that. But what you can also do with this is give it a little more contrast by lightening it just a little bit. So to do that, you're gonna click on this frame and duplicate it. Place it directly on top. And this time we're going to replace the photo with a color and we're going to use the color white. So go over here to colors, grab white, and then bring the transparency down to like 20% is usually pretty good. There we go. It just gives it like a little extra contrast having that slightly lighter image with that glass effect right there. You can leave it like this. It's perfectly okay. But you'll notice on this image, it has this very thin white border, and that is meant to mimic sort of the reflection on the edges of that glass. So to create that, all you're gonna do is go, I'll go back up to this one right here. Go to one of the Canva shapes. If your glass has rounded corners, you want to match the roundness of those corners with this shape right here. So I'm just gonna place this directly on top. It's pretty close. I don't think I have to make too many adjustments with that. If you find that the image that you're using, the shape that you're using, isn't quite the same roundness of the corners, then you're going to just adjust it here with your border style and your corner rounding. We're going to give this a border of about 2 for this one. You can adjust accordingly. And I'm not 61, 2. That's a little better. And we're going to make this white. So I'm going to click on my border color right here and make it white. And then we need to get rid of this fill right here. So just click on the fill and click on no color right here. There we go. And there you have that nice little edged white border. If you want to give this a little extra dimension, you can add some drop shadows to this. There's two ways you can do that. One is by using a drop shadow element in Canva, and the other is by manipulating the photo. So let's do the drop shadow first. So if you go to shadows and go to graphics, there's a whole bunch of drop shadows in here. And I know they're kind of hard to see on the black, but there's a whole bunch of shadows in here, different shapes, different styles. And you can just pick one that's going to work with the shape or style that you're working with. So I have one that I had already used before. It's this shadow right here. I'm going to bring this size down a little bit so that it matches the size of my shape. And then I'm going to bring this down right about here, maybe a little bit smaller. There we go. Bring it right about here. Change the position because you want the shadow to be behind your frosted glass. So we're just going to drag this all the way down so that it's just above your main layer right here. And then this is a little on the dark side for me, so I'm just going to bring the transparency down a little bit. And then maybe just a little smaller, I think, on this shadow. There we go. Like that. There we go. And that just gave it a little extra depth. Oh, and I accidentally moved my border. Let's put that back. There we go. So that's one method of giving it a drop shadow. The second method is by actually taking the blurred effect that you created and downloading that and bringing it back into Canva. So let's go do that. So here we have this blurred image right here. I'm going to delete the background temporarily right there. You'll download this to your device. So click share and download. Make sure it's PNG and make sure it's transparent background, and then click download. And then we're going to bring it right back into Canva. I think I already have one in here from before. I do. That's okay. Let me bring my image back in that I had before. So let me just copy this photo, bring that back here, copy photo, bring that back to this page. Here we go. And then you're going to bring this blurred image right in. So there's our blurry image. Now, when you bring this back into Canva, you'll notice that the image you imported is a little smaller than your original. You want to make it the same size. So just take the image, drag it so that the top corner matches the top corner of your original, and then drag the bottom corner handles to match the bottom. And this will make it the exact same size and proportion as your original image. Once that's done, you're going to click on this image here, click edit photo. And this time we're going to give it a shadow effect like this. Click on shadows. You can give it a glow effect where it has sort of that shadow all the way around it, or you can give it just a drop shadow. But now watch what happens when I do that. When I click the drop shadow here, see how it made my image just a little bit smaller? Anytime you add a shadow effect to an image in Canva, it crops that image just ever so slightly. It just brings it down a little bit. So to fix that, all you're going to do is just drag your handles up or down to make sure that your size is back in proportion to where it was before. And it doesn't take much to get that alignment back how it was before. And there you have that drop shadow effect. Now you can also take this glass and give it sort of like a textured glass look. You'll notice right here, let me zoom in a little bit so you can see this. See how this glass has kind of this honeycomb effect? Well, you can do that as well with this. Because we started with a Canva frame, we can drop anything we want to into that frame, even something that has texture to it. So let me just take my border away for a minute and move that border out here. And I'm going to remove the texture so you can see what happens. So here I have just, here's that just plain frame right here. And actually, where's my transparency? Bring it all the way back up. This was my plain frame. So now you'll go to elements and then just search for something that has a texture to it. And I think I'm gonna make mine white. I wanna keep it a white texture. White texture, go to photos. And here I have all of these options right here. I've got all different types of texture effects that I can use. Here's that honeycomb effect that I had a minute ago. So all you'll do is take that texture, drag it into the frame, and then bring down the transparency. So click right here. And then back down to whatever percentage you want, maybe 20%, maybe a little bit less. It's entirely up to you. And then you can bring your frame, your white border frame that we did at the end, right on top like that to give it sort of like that textured look. You can even go so far as to have a lot of fun with this and add something like this, where it looks like it's a hanging sign in front of that image. So all I did with this was I took the image that I had originally downloaded and brought back into Canva. That's this one right here. I just added some little circles. I just added a shape, added a couple little circles right here and gave them kind of a gray look. You don't really want it white. It's going to be a little too stark. Give it like a little bit of a gray look. And then I just went into the graphics section. I found a fun little rope and just placed that right here on top. So it looks like it has this sign effect. Then you'll just take this and download it one more time into Canva. And you want to make sure it's transparent again, download. And then we're going to bring it back into Canva. And then we're going to show you how you just add that little drop shadow to this as well. And it looks like it, see right here, you've got that little, let me zoom in, got that little drop shadow right behind that rope right there. And that drop shadow right there behind that sign, you can do it that way as well by this effect. So let me zoom out. Let me bring that frame back in. All right, drag that in. And then if I want to just copy my image, let me just copy my image onto a new page. Here's my image. Here is that border with the lines that look like the sign. Again, I have to make this the same size as my original. So I'm just gonna drag it like this. And then once again, I can click edit photo, give it that drop shadow right there. And like I said before, if it's slightly misaligned right here, because Canva will shrink that image, you can just drag and adjust the handles just a little bit to bring it back into proportion like that. Just like that. And then at the very end, you can add whatever text that you would like on top of that. If you found this helpful, please make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.